Today, I'm going to be talking about spinal cords. Just a note to say that I'm not a healthcare professional, just a girl with a spinal cord injury sharing what I have learned. So a spinal cord injury is what I have, and I'm a T4 paraplegic. In this video series, I'm going to go through the different parts of having a spinal cord injury, such as bladder, bowel, skin, all different things. But this is the first video of the series, and I'm going to explain the spinal cord and how you are tested to find what your spinal cord injury is. So I'll start with trying to explain what the spinal cord is. It's a long structure of nerve tissue which begins at the end of the brainstem and continues down to the bottom of the spine. It consists of nerves that carry messages between the brain and the rest of the body. It's like a phone cord connecting your brain to your muscles and your organs, the way it connects and communicates with each other. And a column of bones called vertebrae make up the spine to protect the spinal cord. Now, where you are damaged in your spinal cord determines what parts of your body may be impaired. At the bottom of the spine is the sacral, which is the S1 to S5 part of your spinal cord. So if damaged, can affect the function of your hips, legs, bowel, and bladder. Further up is the lumbar, which is the L1 to L5 part of your spinal cord, which if damaged, can affect your hips, quadriceps, hamstrings, and foot. Then up to the thoracic, which is where I am damaged, which ranges from T1 to T12. If damaged, can affect from your toes up to your abdominals and trunk. And at T1, can even start to affect parts of your hands. The last section is cervical, which is C1 to C8. If you damage this area, it can affect from your feet up to your hands, fingers, shoulders, diaphragm, breathing muscles, and your neck muscles. You should take note that a spinal cord injury can also affect blood pressure, temperature, blood circulation, and control of bladder, bowel, and sexual function. Now, it's not only where you are damaged in your spinal cord, but how you are damaged. Let me explain. Spinal nerves emerge from the spinal cord between the vertebrae, which there are 31 pairs of spinal nerves. Each nerve emerges in two short branches, one at the front, which is the motor or anterior root, and then one at the back, which is the sensory or posterior root of the spinal cord. The motor roots carry commands from the brain to move parts of the body, and the sensory roots carry information of a touch to the brain. How damaged the spinal cord is affects if these messages can get through or not. Some motor commands may get through, or you may have a slight altered sensation. So just imagine a whole bunch of strings, and each string is a different nerve. If one string is not damaged, it will still connect through. So what I'm saying is, if a nerve is not damaged, it will still connect through, whatever it may be, that one nerve, it will still connect through. When you get a spinal cord injury, you're told what your level of injury is, if you're an incomplete or complete, and what your ASIA impairment scale is. A complete is a total lack of sensory or motor function below the level of injury, so no messages can get through. An incomplete means an individual is found to have some preservation of sensation or motor function at the lowest segment of the spinal cord. Being an incomplete doesn't necessarily mean you're going to walk again. It just means some of those motor or sensory messages can get through. So that piece of string is not damaged. so your nerves are still intact. It could be something like you have a bit of sensory, so you can feel the stomach here, which I can feel the stomach here. The way you are categorized with your injury is by your neurological level and your ASIA impairment scale. The neurological level is the most lowest level of the spinal cord with intact sensation and anti-gravity muscle function strength, muscle grade 3 or more. Provided that there is normal intact sensory and motor function above the level. That means you have at least movement against gravity. Maybe not resistance, but at least gravity. The ASIA impairment scale is a scoring system used to define the level of impairment of your sensory and motor function after a spinal cord injury. And it can be used to assess how you're going during the rehab. A health professional, such as a doctor or a physio, takes you for the test. When you're performing the test, you have to be laying down and you have to test both the left side and the right side. There are five parts to the spinal cord injury classification. 1, determine sensory level for the right and left side. 2, determine motor level for right and left side. 3, determine the neurological level. 4, determine whether the injury is complete or incomplete. 5, determine ASIA impairment scale grade. One thing to remember when performing this test is that the patient shouldn't be in spinal shock. That way you get a more true result. If you're not sure what spinal shock is, I'll put a link to a video describing what it is in the description below. First, the sensory examination, which is tested with light touch, such as a cotton ball and a pinprick. And the scoring system uses a 3-point scale. 0 is no sensation, 1 is impaired sensation, 2 is normal sensation. Next part is the motor examination. For this, different sections of muscles are checked for strength and resistance, which is graded from 0 to 5 according to the MRC grading. The last part is the anorectal examination, which is vital in determining what your ASIA impairment scale is. You see, you might have sensory or motor function below your level of injury, but you can only be considered an incomplete if you have sensory or motor function in this examination. How it is done for the sensory is a gentle pressure is applied to the anorectal wall by the examiner's finger. The patient is asked what they feel, and perceived pressure is graded as absent or present. For motor, the patient is asked to voluntarily contract the external anal sphincter around the examiner's finger. The contraction is scored as absent or present. Once the test has finished, the scores are added up and that determines what the ASIA impairment scale is. ASIA A is a complete with no sensory or motor function preserved in sacral segments S4 to S5. ASIA B is sensory incomplete, which is sensory but not motor function is preserved below the neurological level and includes the sacral segments S4 to S5. ASIA C is motor incomplete, which is motor function preserved below the neurological level and more than half, 50% of key muscles below the neurological level have muscle grade less than 3. ASIA D is incomplete. Motor function is preserved below the neurological level and at least half of key muscles below the neurological level have a muscle grade greater than or equal to 3. ASIA E is when sensory and motor functions are normal. So in this video, we've covered the spinal cord and how to test your impairment scale. scale. And I hope this video helps you understand the spinal cord a little better. What I want you to remember is every spinal cord injury is different, things can change, and there's always exceptions to the rule. In fact, I don't think anybody really knows for sure, but what this test can do for sure is tell you what your injury is at that given time. Something you will learn is spinal injuries, nothing's black and white, everything's in the gray area, and no one can predict what is going to happen to you in the future for sure. What you can tell is what you are at that given time. Keep an eye out for more videos going into the different parts of having a spinal cord injury. And remember to subscribe. Also, if you like this video, click that thumbs up. And sorry there's a lot of medical jargon, but it's helpful to know.